process driven by polls. Every senator's got to make their own determination based upon the evidence.
So I hear you on that. And just picking up on the request from Senator Schumer for those four fact witnesses, I think a lot of Americans want to hear what Mick Mulvaney would testify to, what John Bolton would have to say. But it is also a fact that back in 1999, during the Senate trial to impeach President Clinton, then newly a senator, Chuck Schumer, didn't want any new evidence or testimony admitted into that trial. And last night, Republican Senator John Cornyn, of course, a member of the leadership team, told CNN, quote, "The House passed articles of impeachment. We are the jury, so we shouldn't be trying to retry it or redo something they have already had a shot at." He says no new evidence. Who's right, Senator Cornyn now and Chuck Schumer in 99, or Chuck Schumer today?
Look, all I can tell you is what I believe should happen. The predicate here, obviously, is the investigation conducted by the House, an exhaustive review of the evidence with sworn testimony. It's interesting that the folks who have made the case in a very compelling way, I would argue, against the president's point of view, have all been under oath. I'm not sure we've had anyone under oath who's made the opposite conclusion. But hey, look, it's going to be a determination we have to make individually, reviewing all the evidence. I think that these witnesses that Senator Schumer has proposed would supplement and fill in some of the information that we don't have right now. But I think what's already on the record is compelling. Look, Poppy, let me just tell you personally, when I read the memorandum of that call, I was offended personally. Here's why. Because as a public official, you're always supposed to keep a very bright line between the work you do in government and how you do that work and the work you do as a candidate. And there are ways to obtain information for an election. You cannot use a government telephone or do it on government property or do it in a way that violates your oath of office. That's very troubling. It's even worse. And this offense has greater gravity because it involved foreign assistance, interfering in a national election, and investigating a political opponent. We've never seen this before in American history.
I appreciate your time. I'm